during the media registration session, and that's courtesy of our friends from Resorts World Singapore who are seated right there among us. Thank you, Robin. Looking forward to continued collaboration. And moving on to the Singapore Youth Olympic Games in 2010. The first Youth Olympic Games will be held in Singapore from the 14th to 26th of August in 2010. Singapore will welcome visitors from around the world, including 5,000 youth athletes between the ages of 14 and 18, and officials, and over 500,000 spectators. Youth athletes will compete in 26 sports across a total of 201 events and take part in over 50 culture and education program activities. In July 2010, the Olympic flame for the first YOG will be lit in Greece, the birthplace of Olympics as we know, and journey to one city each in Africa, America, Asia, Europe and Oceania before culminating in Singapore in early August 2010. At each city, the Youth Olympic flame will be welcomed with a city celebration. Athletes and youths in these continents will be invited to witness the lighting of the cauldron and join in city celebrations. In Singapore, the Youth Olympic flame will visit all parts of the city-state in a traditional torch relay run and arrive at the float at Marina Bay for lighting of the cauldron at the Singapore 2010 opening ceremony. The Youth Olympic Games will bring to reality Singapore's vision as a choice destination for major international events and allow us to showcase the exciting tourism transformations that are taking place right now. And overseas, we're also making waves. Singapore's participation in the World Expo 2010 Shanghai, China is our largest to date at the World Expo. This signifies our strong and close bilateral relations with China. The 3,000 square meter Singapore Pavilion themed Urban Symphony will showcase Singapore's achievements in urban planning, water technology and environmental services while promoting closer people-to-people relations between China and Singapore. The pavilion will also highlight Singapore's ability to offer a high quality and integrated environment to live, work and play within a compact area through sustainable planning and development. Still making waves, the International Cruise Terminal. To be completed in the year 2011, the International Cruise Terminal at Marina South will double Singapore's berth capacity and enable more cruise ships to home port and call on Singapore and Asia. The new terminal will also be able to accommodate the largest cruise ships that are being built now, the Oasis class. Construction work has commenced with the recent award of the civil engineering contract and the groundbreaking ceremony on the 2nd of October. Singapore's first purpose-built cruise terminal was designed to ensure smooth and seamless accessibility for both passengers and cruise ships. Its state-of-the-art functional capabilities and distinctive nautical-themed architecture harmonizes with the terminal's functions and settings to enhance the sense of arrival for cruise passengers. It will also add to the architectural gems of Singapore's skyline in the Marina Bay area. Complementing the existing Singapore Cruise Centre at the Southern Waterfront Precinct, the cruise facilities, or the ICT, will significantly increase Singapore's cruise passenger handling capacity and help to meet Singapore's target of achieving 1.6 million cruise passenger throughput by the year 2015. Now, just when you think that we've run out of ideas, there are other new products which we would like to highlight over the next few years. There's a Fullerton Bay Hotel at Clifford Pier, Gardens by the Bay, as you can tell, which will be ready in the year 2011. The National Art Gallery, which will be housed in Singapore's former Supreme Court and City Hall. Singapore's fourth local university will be ready in 2011, offering programs in engineering and applied science, business and information technology, and architecture and design. Three new hospitals will also be built between 2010 and 2011, catering to an anticipated increase in healthcare visitors. Now, of course, we are constantly planning and looking far, far ahead. Looking ahead to 2010, the Singapore Tourism Board has developed a new tourism roadmap called Tourism Compass 2020. This will be an enhancement of Tourism 2015, our tourism blueprint, launched in 2005 to outline our vision to become Asia's leading MICE city leisure destination and services center. Tourism Compass 2020 aims to identify and capitalize on emerging opportunities afforded by new travel trends so that we can further the tourism sector's contribution as a key driver of Singapore's economy. I'm sure everybody's saying finally. With so much to look forward to, the SCB is optimistic about Singapore's continued appeal supported by these new upcoming products and developments. More importantly, what drives people to Singapore and back to Singapore is not just the new products or hardware, but also the total experience that you get when you come here. The dining, the nightlife, the shopping, the convenience of getting around the island, and the professionalism of our MICE industry and the warmth of our people. We will continue to stay focused on our customers, delivering value and meeting their needs. Thank you. I'm Umar, my boss, the Executive Director of the Communications Division, Mr. Chu Tong Heng, who is Director of Destination Marketing, and Ms. Jacqueline Ng, who is the Director of Industry Development of the Business Travel and MICE Group. Now, I'd like to invite you to ask questions, but please do identify yourselves and the media agency they represent when you ask a question. Thank you.
Okay, maybe, sorry, before that, just a quick one. I think I'd like to thank everyone for the patience in going through the slides that we had. As you can see, we started off the year being fairly cautious given the economic situation, and that resulted in the projections that Angeline shared. But you can see that 2009, even as we are slightly past three-quarter way through 2009, has been a very busy year for us. We'll continue to be busy in the last quarter, and if you look at our performance historically, second half is usually stronger than the first half. And we have, if there are three peak travel months in a year, two of them are in the second half, which is typically July and December. So we are looking forward to, you know, finishing off strongly, and we are fairly confident that we will stay on track meeting our projections. And you also see that you know, going forward there are many more projects. So that's a quick summary of what the Singapore story has been in 2009. This has been a question that has surfaced year on year, every year. It's not a new thing, you know. I've been asked this question 4 years ago, 5 years ago. And the point is, that hasn't stopped visitors coming to Singapore. We've had record VAs year on year, barring last year, right? We've had record visitors every year.
So what that means really is that if we provide the right kind of value proposition, we think that people will be willing to pay.
And the other point is, you know, the businesses here, our industry partners, they will adjust to market. I mean, if you take F1 as an example, you know, hotel prices this year were adjusted downwards from 30 to 50% relative to last year. So, I mean, businesses will adjust relative to what, you know, market will want, what market is going to be paid. And the other point I will add as well is, if you look at F1, it's not a cheap event for people to fly in, you know, to want to watch an F1. And yet they do. I mean, last year, we don't have the figures for this year yet, but last year, more than 40,000 overseas visitors come to Singapore to watch F1. Is that cheap? Is that expensive? It's relative. Why? Because they do see the value in that when they are here, they get to experience a race like no other. So I think we get hung up on this issue of, are you cheaper than the other guy? I think Singapore will get nowhere. I think we have to focus on what is it that we offer to the customer that they make them say, hey, you know, despite me having to pay X dollars more, I'll still come. I think that's our challenge, that's our focus, it has all been there. And we are on the right path. If you look at our first chart, and we showed the charts, right, where our TR, our VA figures are, every year, even last year, when we are having the economic downturn, you know, when we saw the beginning of the economic downturn in the second half, even last year, we managed to get record TR. What that means is this, that while we are increasing our VA, we are increasing the expenditure. So we are attracting actually people who are willing to pay more when they come to Singapore. So I think we are not so hung up, we're not apologetic for the fact that we're not the cheapest guy around. But But we want to make sure when they are here, they have a good experience. Okay.